subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what is profit loss and what are the important problems of profit and loss and what are the important formulae of profit and loss. All these things we are going to see in this video. So now let's begin this video without any delay. So coming to the profit and loss, first we need to learn what are the basic formulae which will be helpful and useful to solve any kind of problems. First we need to know how to find the profit of any product, okay? So if there is a problem and if they give a problem and if they ask us to find what is profit, then here is the formula which will be helpful. That okay, then you need to use this formula. In order to find what is profit, we need to subtract selling price and cost price. Selling price minus cost price. Okay, selling price can be denoted as SP. Cost price is denoted as CP. Profit is denoted as P. P is equal to SP minus CP. That is, if you subtract the selling price and cost price, then we will be getting profit. And other important thing is, profit is also called as gain. Okay, profit is also called as gain. So this is first important formula. If you wanted to find profit, you need to subtract selling price and cost price. Now let's see how can we calculate, how can we find loss. Okay, loss is also very easy. When we subtract cost price and selling price, then we get loss. Let's denote loss as L, cost price as CP and selling price as SP. When we subtract cost price and selling price, we will get loss. Okay, remember this point. In profit, selling price will be more, and from selling price we will subtract cost price. But in loss, cost price will be more and selling price will be less. Okay, so now let's see what is selling price and cost price. Okay, selling price, the price at which the product is sold is called selling price. Okay, the price at which the product is sold is called selling price. Next, what is cost price? Cost price, in the name itself they are saying, the cost of the product is called cost price. Okay, so now let's see how can we calculate gain percentage. How can we calculate gain percentage? Okay, so what is the problem? What is the formula for calculation of gain percentage? Gain by CP into 100, that is gain by cost price is cost price into 100. Okay, now what is the formula for loss percentage? Loss percentage formula is also very easy. Loss divided by cost price into 100. Okay, so either it is gain percentage or loss percentage, denominator will be same, into 100 is same, only the numerator will be changed. Okay, in gain percentage, gain divided by CP into 100. In loss percentage, loss divided by CP into 100. Okay. In denominator, commonly there will be only CP. Okay. Clear till here. If you want, you can just take the screenshot. So coming to the next formula. Now let's see what is the formula for selling price. Selling price. Okay, so what is the formula for selling price? Selling price is equal to selling price is equal to 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100 into cost price. Okay, 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100 into cost price. This is selling price when there is a gain. Okay, so now let's see what is the formula for selling price when there is loss. Loss is also very easy. The formula for loss is also very easy. 100 minus loss percentage divided by 100 into CP. Okay, we did nothing. Instead of plus, we wrote minus. Instead of gain percentage, we wrote loss percentage. That list rest all, it's same with the formula. Okay, so now let's see what is the formula for cost price. Okay, formula for cost price when we get gain or when we get loss. First, let's see for gain. It is very, very easy. I'll tell you how to remember the formula. Consider this formula, okay? Because first we are considering for gain, okay? So consider this formula and take the denominator and write as it is. We just took the denominator and wrote in numerator side, on numerator side, and numerator we are writing in denominator side, okay? 100 plus gain percentage into, clear till here? We just did nothing. The denominator side we wrote on numerator side and vice versa. We took this numerator and wrote it on the denominator side. Clear till here? Into here there is CP, so logic here we are writing SP, selling price. Easy. So this is the cost price formula when we get gain. Now let's see what is the cost price formula when we get loss. Same, take this denominator and write on numerator side, divided by numerator side comes down, which is denominator 100 minus loss percentage into CP becomes SP. That's it. So like this, logically we can remember the formulae. So now let's start solving problems from profit and loss. Let's see this question. The question is, the cost price of 20 articles is same as selling price of X articles. Then find X. Okay, so what are they saying? Cost price of 20 articles is equal to selling price of X articles. Okay, then find X. This is the question. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this problem. So first, what we are doing is, let cost price of each article be rupee 1. Okay, so we know what is the cost. So cost price of 20 articles is equal to selling price of X articles. What is X? This is the question. So first, let's assume, let cost price of each article be rupee 1. Okay, here what we are assuming, we are just assuming cost price of one article is rupee 1. Okay, so how many products we have X? Then cost price of X articles will be how much? X articles will be rupees X. Clear till here? We are just assuming cost price of each article is rupee 1, but here we have X articles, so cost price of X articles is rupees X. But here, what are they saying? Then what is selling price of X? Okay, what is the selling price of eggs? It is 20 rupees 20. Cost price of x articles we assumed as x, because we assumed cost price of each article, that is one article is rupee 1, then the cost price of one article is rupees 1. So obviously when there are x articles, the cost of x cost price of x articles will be rupees x. Clear till here? Now in the question they gave selling price of x. We need to find selling price of x. What is equal to selling price of x? Cost price of 20. 20 articles. See, when one article rupee is one, so when we assumed one article price as rupee 1, then cost price of 20 articles will be rupees 20. Clear till here? So here we know the cost price and we know the selling price. Now let's find what is the profit. And we know the formula of profit also. Selling price minus cost price is the profit. What is selling price? Selling price is nothing but rupees 20 minus cost price is x. Okay, so profit is equal to 20 minus x. And in question they also gave profit percentage is equal to 25%. Okay, in question only they gave this. So profit percentage is equal to 25%. We all know this. And we also know what is the formula for profit percentage. Profit percentage formula is profit percentage formula is by what is profit value? 20 minus x. Profit by profit is nothing but selling price minus cost price, right? So we wrote it directly. Selling price minus cost price divided by selling price minus cost price divided by cost price into 100. Okay. Into 100. And we know what is the profit percentage. Profit percentage is 25. So clear till here? Now we need to solve this. Okay, divided by cost price. What is cost price? X into 100. And in question they gave profit percentage. What is profit percentage? 25. So we have written it directly. So now we need to solve this equation. Okay, now let's solve this. 20 into 100 is 2000. 20 into 100 is 2000 minus x into 100 is 100x. 100x divided by x, denominator we are writing as it is equal to 25. Clear till here? Okay. 2000 minus 100x divided by x is equal to 25. This is prof. We are finding this. Okay. So now our goal is to find the. In question, we are asked to find the value of x. So we are doing the same. So next, we are writing the same thing. 2000 minus 100x is equal to x we are sending to right hand side, so divided by x when it goes to right hand side becomes into x. Okay, 25 into x is 25x. So we need to solve this. 2000 is equal to 25x minus 100x when it goes to right hand side it becomes plus 100x. Okay, plus 100x. Now 2000 is equal to 25x plus 100x is 125x. Okay, so x is equal to 2000 divided by 125, and 125 ones are 125, 16s are 2000. Okay, so x is equal to 16. So what is the question? They are asking us to find x. So we finally found x. X is equal to 16. Okay.
Yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.